Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about different ways you can see the volumes connected to your Mac. Now, a volume is basically a disk that's connected to your Mac. Could be your internal drive, could be an external drive, could be a thumb drive, could be a camera hooked up to your Mac or an SD card from a camera that's put into the slot on the side of your MacBook. It could be a shared drive. It could even be a disk like a DVD inserted into your Mac. There are many ways to view the volumes hooked up to your Mac. One is in a Finder window, you'll see under Devices a list of different volumes. And you can see how I can easily hide that and show that, so you might not see it there. Also, if you're in Finder under Finder Preferences, you can decide what to show on the desktop. And there's different types of volumes. So for instance, here I can select to have all the hard disks shown. You can see them all appearing here. I can also say not have all the hard disks but only external disks or only CDs and DVDs. And there's all sorts of different things that I can select to customize what shows up here on my desktop. Another way to view all the volumes is in a Finder window like this. If I command click on the title here, you can see I can move up the hierarchy. You can go from Documents to my User folder to the General Users folder to the Macintosh hard drive, which is my internal drive, or the level above that, which is the name of my computer. And when I do that, I can see a list of all the different volumes. I've got a CD here. I've got a bunch of internal drives. I've got a thumb drive. I've got even my network here, which I click on and then see all the shared network drives. Another way to get there would be use the Go menu and go Computer. And takes you to that same spot. You can also do Command Shift G, or it's just go to Folder here and you can go slash Volumes, and this will take you to your list of volumes here. And what you can do with this here is you can actually drag this volumes here to the dock. And this is handy. A lot of people do this. Drag it to the right side of the dock here, and then you get a stack that is all of your volumes. And you can, of course, customize this stack to open in a different way. Say you want to open it as a list instead, and you can easily get to all the different volumes that you have connected at any time. Now let's say you're editing a document like Harriman Text Edit, and I want to save something to one of these volumes. I can do that many ways. In this case, since it's already a document that exists, I'm going to use the Move To function, which is equivalent to kind of Save As. And I'm going to, in Where, choose. And I can go to Devices here and choose one of these devices to save it to. Obviously I can't save it to the optical drive here, but I can save it to say that thumb drive or some other drive here and move it there. So you can find that in all sorts of different things. Like here I'm going to create a new text edit document. I'm going to save it and I'm going to select one of these devices here, and I can expand that and then go deeper down into you see I'm on my computer there, so I get that same list of volumes, and now I can go into this and view it just like I can in the Finder using different ways of viewing lists. So I hope you found this tip useful. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.